spotlight on my face. There was love all around me, but I was looking for revenge. Thank God it never found me. Would have been the end. Welcome back to the Strike Fly Fishing Club YouTube channel. Or if you're viewing it on the website, welcome to our new website. Today I'm going to show you how to make a very popular and famous fly, which is called the Blakestone Buzzer. So we're using Camasan B110 size 12 grubber hooks, and the thread I'm using is UTC 70. First thing you want to do is catch in your thread and take it down until it's in line with the barb or the point of the hook. When you get this, cut off the tag, and at this point you want to take some fine silver wire, cut off about 2 to 3 inches long, catch your wire in here, pull it back about a mil, 2 mils from the actual eye, and at this point you want to touch and turns, keeping the wire on the side of the hook or above the hook or below it. You decide where you want it, but always keep it on that side. Don't let it twist around the hook. We're going to go about halfway around the bend. At this point you can take whatever color you want. I like red, the holographic. So we're going to cut about 2 inches of this, put it on the side, turn it round, and it should go on to the back. Tie it in, 3 or 4 turns, then touch and turns back up. You want to stop basically where you started, just roughly there. At this point take your holographic, bring it over the back like a shell back, couple of loose turns, get it in shape so it's completely level on the back. If it's not, at this point you can move it about. So sometimes it can be footery, but this can also be done with mylar pearl. So once you get it where you want, tight turns, a couple of turns up, and tidy up. Then bring your wire up, keeping your holographic always on the back. At this point you want about 5 to 6 turns. Get the hair, put a 90 degree bend in the wire, and take it on up to the outer hook. At this point hold the thread tight, wiggle the wire, which should break. And what we're going to do is we're going to come back about halfway back, take again whatever color you prefer. I'm going to use the hot orange bats. Now remember, when you're putting in the bats, to have it that they're bending away from each other. This means then when you tie them in and fold them back, they're the right way around and they're showing the right colours, etc. So just pinch the both of them in at each side, try and keep them pretty even, tie back until where your thread stop or your wire stop. A few turns to keep that in. Then you want to take some peacock hair, 3 strands, line the bottom of them up, and then break about an inch off the top, as this is very brittle. You get the hair, loose turn, pull them back just behind the eye, and then tie them in. You can do a few turns up and down, then stop at the eye. Now you want to twist the peacock hair together, but not too much that it's going to break. Once you get this, start turning it round
Bringing it up towards the eye. Once you get the hair, catch it in. Couple of turns. Hold it tight and it'll break off. At this point, you can fold both your bats forward. Hold them at the side. Loose turn to catch them. Just have a look to make sure they're where you want them. And then tighten on. So just form the head. Small head. Stop at the eye. Hold your thread tight. Give them a wiggle. They should break away free. At this point, I'm going to whip finish. And that will be us done. Once you've whip finished, just take your varnish. I'm using Vineyard varnish and the applicator bottle, which is really handy doing things like this. Just a wee bit of varnish, and that's it done. So there you go, that is the Blakestone buzzer. A great little fly for the still waters at this time of year. You can fish this fly on the pointer and perhaps use a Davy McPhail midge pupa pattern. But there you go, that's my version of the Blakestone buzzer. Until next time, happy rabbins.